Pardon?
Yes, sir.
Very good. I got a bunch of, I just got warrants. It's not the same deposit box over here on the current screen. Okay. Thank you, bye. Sorry for talking so loud. Very true, something like that.
So I'm just going to be talking to my camera, and everybody's having to get off this bus because this driver's doing this stupid thing. I'm recording this.
You're not allowed to run a camera on.
Oh yes, I am. You're running one on me. I can run one on you. And I've done this before, my man. There's a camera right there on top of your head with microphones on it. The thing is, when you have an issue with a driver, and you ask them to give you a copy of that camera, that film, they won't give you one.
Yeah, I have no idea.
Hell no.
I don't know the rules.
And if you try to subpoena it in court, they'll say, well, we didn't keep it. You know, it's pretty good, eh? A while ago, they banned me from Metro Transit because I asked to get off a bus and they wouldn't let me off. And I took it to court and the judge couldn't believe it. He threw the whole thing out because he knew I wasn't wrong. They actually banned me from Metro Transit because I asked to get off a bus and they wouldn't let me off the bus. At a bus terminal.
I got no comment on what you're saying.
That's all right.
Yeah. I'm in the dark.
So it's. Oops. I'm just talking in my camera. It's 3:23, November 5th, 2011. Yeah, that's pretty funny. And I'm on bus 1151, Route 7. One of these days somebody's gonna take this driver to court for wasting people's time like this. So more people are having to leave this bus. Yeah, take care, man. Are nuts, like I'm doing anything. I'm sitting here and I was talking to that man and the driver and took his on my conversation. you plan on harassing me, you better call the police.
Okay.
Thank you. I'm gonna wait for him to get the police. I told him to call the police.
You're off the bus.
Only if I want to get off, right?
No.
Really?
You have been removed from the bus.
Well, I'm not moving. I told him to call the police because you guys are harassing me.
Well, you're not going nowhere on this bus. You're off.
Hello.
Hi, how are you today?
That could be a lot better.
Yeah, I hear you have some problems.
Not me. He is.
Oh, what's going on?
I talk like this because I don't breathe well, right? But this driver is really extraordinary. I mean, you need to look at this tape. I get on here, the man that I was sitting here, I was talking with him for a while before we ever got on the bus, right? Yeah. And I asked the driver to please hook the hooks onto the metal hoops because most of them won't bother doing that. They'll put it on the straps.
Right.
And he starts with his mouth on me. He says, well, I know how to do things. And yeah, I didn't hear it bang on my framework, so I thought he put it on the strap. Because the chair, it twists the chair around when they put it on the strap. And I've got a broken back, so I have to ask drivers. Often they won't put it on the metal hook. So he continues with all kinds of smart remarks. I tried to respond to him, to some of them, and I realized this is a losing battle. So I ignored him. I didn't want to answer him anymore. But the guy that I was talking to, him and I had been talking for like an hour, right? So he's watching what's going on. The guy behind here says, well, he's supporting me, because I hadn't done anything. And I'm trying to ignore him, and the driver continues hassling me. He's talking really loud, and I'm saying to people, he keeps saying things to me, so I'm going to tell him what I said to this person that I was talking to. I said, the reason why, he says to me, like, oh, we know how to do things. Like, he's just throwing a whole bunch of stuff at me. And I said, look, I'm the guy that filed the human rights complaint against Metro Transit because of the way I've been treated, and I won my case. And the last time, after that, they banned me from the buses. So I went to court. And the judge threw it out because I didn't do anything wrong. So I told him, I said, I already know how all this works. I've already filed, I write reports for the government. And I'm very aware of how they tie the chairs down. But a lot of drivers won't secure my chair properly. A lot of times they won't put that one in at all, right? And a lot of these ratchets don't work and they let go. So what I do when I'm tied down is I check to see if my chair is moving. So a lot of times it moves all over the place. And in my condition, I can't have the chair moving. So what happened here is that I'm trying to ignore him. He continues and continues, and I'm thinking, man, oh man, here I go again. I'm getting hassled by a driver. He's got a really bad attitude, and I don't have the time of day for this. There was a full bus, a load of people on this bus, and everybody had to get off the bus because he's holding everybody up. And I wasn't even talking to him. I didn't even want to talk to him. And I'm trying to have a conversation with this guy because he's asking me questions about this chair and what's going on. So I'm explaining things to him. And every time I'm talking to him, the driver pipes in and starts talking really loud, starts saying stupid comments and interfering in my conversation. And I said to the driver, I'm not even talking to you. Why are you talking to me, right? And he just continued and continued. You really need to look at this tape and see that I haven't done anything wrong to anybody. I can't believe that he just put me through this and everybody else on this bus through this.
Do you want a back door? Okay, where are you going?
I'm going up to by the Commons.
I think where we're sitting right now is that...
they only run once an hour, right? Don't they right now?
Yeah, I think what we're facing right now is we've gotten to the point where I believe HR FEMA can't wait.
Oh, I told him to call him because what he's doing is I'm adding to harassing me. I wasn't bothering him. I didn't do anything to him. And he was interfering in my conversation with this man that was over here. And our conversation was very civil. And he kept having comments and things to say. And it was none of his business what I was talking to this man about.
Okay.
And he was interfering in my freedom to speak to somebody else. And I wasn't bothering him.
So you're content at the moment that Metro Transit resolves this?
Well, somebody's got to do something because I don't want to get on buses and be harassed by drivers. Because all I asked him to do was one thing, to hook my chair on with the steel thing. And then his attitude started.
Okay, well, we'll wait for them to arrive, I guess, and we'll see what...
Well, I need you to retrieve this tape because I'm gonna lay charges against this driver.
Okay.
He doesn't have any right to harass me like this.
I say, well, I'll wait till HRP arrive and they can decide how they want to handle it. And we'll take it from there. Folks, I apologize for the delay. It's really unavoidable. We just had to wait for HRP to arrive and make a decision. We're going to be delayed a few more minutes because HRP is coming to resolve this. So we have to wait until they arrive, so I apologize. If anybody wanted to give another post on transit, I'll touch you guys. Okay, sir, it shouldn't take too long.
So I'm going to end the tape right now to save my battery, and I'll turn it back on if I need to.